Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Caterpillar, the last of the bigger ships with size 3 shield generators. This video is possible because of Jack Axton, who gave us access to his Caterpillar. I don't own one. Well, in the past there were a lot of problems with the Caterpillar, and I'm sure they are still here. The problems were because of the stretched, elongated shape of the Caterpillar. She took massive damage with shields still way above 80%. We are starting with one size 1 missile. Shields front side 99, stern at maximum. One size 2 missile. Shields front side 99, stern at maximum. One size 3 missile. Shields front side 98, stern at maximum. And one size 4 missile. Shields front side 97, stern at maximum. Six size 4 missiles, and we could already see some damage. Let's find out. Shields front side 75, and the front is red. This is exactly what I meant when I said the more stretched the shape of ship is, the more likely it's taking damage, even though shields are still at 75%. So this is not ballistics are bypassing shields, because this didn't happen to the 600i, not to the Reclaimer, not to the Starfarers, and not to the Hammerhead. We will shoot 6 size 4 missiles one more time, this time at stern, and if nothing changed, stern should not turn red. 6 size 4 missiles, this time aimed at the stern, then aimed at the front was red because the front is very stretched, shooting. Shields stern side 79, front at maximum and no red spot. This is exactly what I meant. If this would be ballistics or bypassing shields, then it wouldn't matter if I aim at the front or at the rear, but it does matter because there is a huge problem right now, actually since 3.0, with shields. And especially when the shape of the ship is stretched. Hopefully this will get fixed sometime in the future, maybe even in 3.6 with the shield rework, but I'm not too hopeful actually. I will test the shield rework though, so don't worry. One size 5 torpedo aimed at the front. Shields front side 94, stern at maximum. And the front is already red. Okay, that's crazy. Let's do it one more time. One size 5 torpedo aimed at the front. Shields front side 94, stern at maximum. Yeah, and the front is already orange or red. Shields at 94%. That's really crazy. And this is real damage. This is not just a display bug. This is real damage. Well, we can now aim at the rear. Usually I always get a new ship when I do my tests, but I think this is pretty much fine. One size 5 torpedo aimed at the rear. Shields 94 stern side front at maximum, and big surprise, no orange or red spot at the rear. Sorry, I sound like a broken record, but I really try to get my point over. This is not ballistics bypassing shields. If it would be, then it wouldn't matter if I aim at the front or at the rear, but it does matter because the front is more stretched and there are more shield holes and more gaps between the shield faces at the front. That's my explanation, and I think it makes sense. Two size 5 torpedoes aimed at the front. Shields 89 front side, stern at maximum, and the front is red. Nice rear view. Two size 5 torpedoes aimed at the rear. Shields 89 stern side, front at maximum, and no red spot. Yeah, this shape is really missing with the poor Caterpillar. One fine day we get shields that don't care if the form of a ship is stretched. Size 9 torpedoes, one size 9 torpedo. Shields front side 83 standard maximum. Oh, what a big surprise, the front is red already. And we are shooting one size 9 torpedo at the rear. Shields stern side 83 front at maximum, and what a big surprise, no red spot at the rear, not even an orange spot. Two size 9 torpedoes aimed at the front. Shields front side 66, stern at maximum, the front of the ship is red. And no visible damage, no cosmetic damage. And two size 9 torpedoes aimed at the rear. Shields 66 stern side, front at maximum, and no red spot on the head. Just a reminder, a ship can get damaged even when you don't see an orange or red spot, when you see something flashing, blinking. However, there's a certain threshold when you see orange or red spots. Three size 9 torpedoes aimed at the front. Shields front side 51, stern at maximum, front is red. No cosmetic damage. Three size 9 torpedoes aimed at the rear. This time we actually should see some damage at the stern. 51 stern side, front at maximum, and the stern is red. Now been hit by 3 size 9 torpedoes. So front was already red when hit by 1 size 9 torpedo. We are shooting now 4 size 9 torpedoes. This might already be a kill. Nope. 36 front side, stern at maximum, front is red. I think we are even in a damaged state. Take a look around. Yeah, we have a little bit of sparks. What's this? Is this water? Yeah, they have.
Sparks!
And smoke. This looks nice. And more smoke. So this is a caterpillar damaged state. But we survived. 4 size 9 torpedoes now. 5 size 9 torpedoes. Auf Wiedersehen. I don't want to repeat myself over and over, so I have those two memes and I use missiles and torpedoes just as a yardstick. And here's our caterpillar. I've done all the big ships now, and from all the ships with size 3 shields, the caterpillar is right now the weakest. I find this sad, but I'm sure she will get her chance in the future. Interestingly, 6 size 4 missiles aimed at the front already turned the front red. This doesn't happen with the 600i, not with the Reclaimer, not with Starfarer or Hammerhead. And even 1 size 5 torpedo aimed at the front turns the front red now. And many people told me, yes, this is because of physical damage is bypassing shields. And I say, no, first of all, we have this mechanic only since 3.5, at least it was in the patch notes of 3.5. And second, if it would be that physical damage is bypassing shields, then it wouldn't matter if I aim at the front or at the rear, but it does matter. 6 size 4 missiles aimed at the front, front red. 6 size 4 missiles aimed at the stern, no red or orange spot. 1 size 5 torpedo aimed at the front, front red, aimed at the rear, nothing. 2 size 5 torpedoes aimed at the front red, aimed at the rear, nothing. Same with 1 and 2 size 9 torpedoes. Only a front hit turns the front red, but the stern hit doesn't turn the stern red. So in my opinion and from my experience, this is about the shape of the ships. The more stretched, the more elongated the shape of a ship is, the more the ship is taking damage, even though shields are still up, and in this case at 94% front side stern max. And this happens partly to the Hammerhead 2, and the Hammerhead has a rougher stretched shape as well, while the Starfarers and Reclaimer don't show much of this behavior. So I guess my theory makes sense, and all this will hopefully get fixed when we get new shields. And I'm not so sure if the shield rework of 3.6 is addressing this, but there will be one shield rework in the future of the game that will fix this. I'm sure about this. Let's take a look at the comparison. Size 3 shields were not buffed, so no difference between 3.4 and 3.5. And we already had this in 3.4, that 6 size 4 missiles aimed at the front turned the front red, but 6 size 4 missiles aimed at the stern don't turn the stern red. Same with size 5 torpedoes. Now interestingly, the caterpillar is now killed by 5 size 9 torpedoes, and she was killed by 4 in 3.4, and I noticed similar things with the other big ships. 600i was killed by 4 and now by 5 size 9 torpedoes. Reclaimer is a special case, so I will skip her. Starfarer is killed by 8 size 9 torpedoes in 3.4 and now by 10, and Hammerhead killed by, I think, 9. Yeah, I have to scroll all the way down by 9. Hammerhead killed by 9 size 9 torpedoes in 3.4 and now by 12. So all the ships need at least 1 size 9 torpedo more for a kill. Hammerhead even 3. And this is strange because CHG didn't alter size 3 shields, and CHG didn't change missile and torpedo damage in 3.5. Well, they did one thing that a little bit, I think maybe 1 or 2% of the physical damage is bypassing shields now, but this shouldn't mean that you need now more torpedoes to kill the bigger ships. I don't know. Would I go into battle in a Caterpillar? Actually, I'm thinking more and more about buying a Caterpillar because I think she's a rather cool ship and she can transport so much cargo. However, her shape and the current shields just don't match. Yeah, I hope that we get new shields soon. And even though I'm not too sure that the shield rework coming in 3.6 is fixing this problem, I surely will test the shield rework and I will look for shield holes, don't worry. So yes, I think the Caterpillar is a fine ship and I would go into battle, I mean cargo runs. But I cannot give her a very high rating right now because of those problems. Maybe a 5 out of 10. And when the problems with the shape and shitty shields, yes I know, it's an alpha, gets sorted out, I will surely give her a much higher rating. Very cool ship, very useful, but has problems with the current shield tech. As always, you can find a link to my spreadsheet and to my Locus wonderful data sheets in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye.